dear students, today I am going to present a paper entitled Neolithic Cultures of Europe and India. Let me first introduce about this topic. The Neolithic period was preceded by Mesolithic era of human history. The domestication of plants and animals is one of the key features of Neolithic culture. Development of agriculture and increase in food resources could support higher population densities. With food production, permanent residences could be established and hunter-gatherer lifestyle was abandoned. The transition from hunting-gathering to food production has been aptly designated as Neolithic Revolution by V. Gordon Child in 1936. Studies on this culture in different parts of the world show different cultural features and traits. Today, we will be discussing the Neolithic cultural development in two important zones of the Old World, that is Europe and India, where we see specific features of this phase of human history. Now, let's come to the Neolithic culture of Europe. In Europe, the Neolithic culture is defined as the period starting with the emergence of farming communities until the appearance of bronze metallurgy, which is the beginning of the Bronze Age. The process of the transformation of European societies from foraging to farming varied from region to region. The use of the term Neolithic does not imply that uniform socio-political developments took place among the various societies in Europe. In some areas, hunting and gathering cultures persisted throughout the period, while other regions witnessed the development of the earlier societies with hereditary inequality. Each Neolithic society had its own cultural developments. These societies probably shared archaeological traits that were linked in some way by language, ethnicity, history, or myth. Now let's come to the next point, beginning and dispersals of agriculture and Neolithic societies in Europe. In present context, most of the major aspects of Neolithic period, such as domesticated plants and animals, pottery, writing, etc., probably came initially from Asia. The staple crops and herd animals of European Neolithic, like wheat and barley, pulses, along with cattle, pigs, sheep, and goats were originally domesticated in the Near East shortly after 10,000 BC. These plants and animals spread to Europe as agricultural practices from Southwest Asia. The expansion of agriculture across Europe took place relatively quickly within a period of approximately 3,000 years. Now come to the next point, early farmers of Europe. Farming made its appearance in Southeast Europe a little after 7000 BC. The archaeological record from France D, cave and other occupation sites in Greece shows that local communities of foragers were taking up agriculture very soon. After its introduction into Europe, and farming seems to have spread ways from Greece through the Mediterranean basin. As farming moved north through the Balkans, it seems likely that some population dispersion of farming groups took place. Elsewhere, however, existing forager groups appear to have adopted domestic plants and animals into their economy. Central Europe was colonized by groups of farmers moving along the major rivers who settled on hillsides covered with fine grained loamy soils, which could be tilled year after year without much loss of fertility. The early farmers who made linear pottery lived in small clusters of timber longhouse. The linear pottery settlement complex at Bailani of Czech Republic has proved to be one of the most important early farming sites in Central Europe since 1953. The site has been dated to around 5400 to 5000 BC. The settlement is spread out over a loess covered landscape on both sides of a small stream. Excavations at several locations have revealed dozens of superimposed longhouse outline and storage pits. Now come to the next point, Middle Neolithic. Around 5500 BC, the Danubian river banks and the Loisic zones of Germany, Czechoslovakia, Austria, and Hungary were occupied by a new farming population. Here they develop distinct cultural features and are commonly referred to as Danubian culture. Around 4500 BC, a number of changes took place among the linear pottery farming communities of Central Europe. In Western Europe, agriculture was gradually taken up by local indigenous populations and has been established as far as the British Isles and southern Scandinavia by 4000 BC. Between 4500 and 3500 BCE, there is evidence of increasing social differentiation among the farming societies of Central Europe, perhaps due in part to the increased emphasis on cattle. New house types and copper working came into use. In the Alps, distinctive settlements developed after around 4000 BC. Often deliberately located on lake shores or in marshy areas with buildings raised on wooden stilts. Now come to late Neolithic. At the beginning of the late Neolithic, most of the Europe was occupied by farmers. Only the coniferous and tundra areas of northern Europe remain inhabited by hunters and gatherers. In some areas, politically complex societies already existed. Around 3500 to 3000 BC, most large settlements disappeared in Central Europe. Invasion of Kurgan pastoralists from the Eurasian steppes contributed to the collapse of large settlements. Other points to local developments such as ecological changes as the causes for the late Neolithic crisis. Now come to the next point, the Neolithic site of Skarabri. The Skarabri site, originally excavated by V. Gordon Child in the 1920s, shows sophisticated domestic life at the northern edge of Neolithic Europe. The people raised sheep and cattle and hunted or scavenged whales and other marine animals. Now let's come to the next point, Southern Iberia. In the late Neolithic of Southern Iberia, at around 3000 to 2200 BC, some farming communities in Southern Iberia fortified their settlements with concentric dry stone walls and built outlying bastions, probably to protect their irrigated fields and crops. They buried their dead in megalithic communal graves with rich grave goods. Megalithic tombs were of several types. Now let us proceed to Neolithic culture of India. Exploration and excavation conducted by various agencies like Archaeological Survey of India, State Department of Archaeology, universities, institutes, and individuals during the last five decades have led to the discovery of a large number of sites covering all parts of the country. On the basis of distribution and cluster of sites, the Neolithic culture of India may broadly be divided into three main broad groups. They are Eastern Group, Southern Group, and Northern Group. Now let us discuss on Eastern Group. In the Eastern Group, the sites of the Vindhyan and the Middle Ganga Plain, Satanagpur Plateau in Bihar, Orissa, and West Bengal. And Northeast Indian hills are included. And exploration and excavations conducted in these regions have highlighted the Neolithic traits. Most of these excavated sites are multicultural sites and yielded archaeological materials ranging from Neolithic to early historical periods. The most distinctive pottery of the Neolithic culture of northern Vindhyan region is court-mark ware, which include handmade pottery made of coarse clay and poorly baked and has court designs on the external surface of the vessels. From some of the excavated sites, stone objects, including blades, scrapers, arrowheads, serrated points, triangles, lunettes, borers, flags, etc. have been unearthed. Excavation yielded several bone objects and bone ornaments. Rice was the staple diet of the people, which was supplemented by fish and animal meat. Besides cultivation of crops and domestication of animals, hunting and fishing also played an important role in the life of the Neolithic people of the mid-Ganga plain. Small-scale excavations at a few sites in Orissa have yielded evidence of Neolithic culture of eastern India. Recent dates obtained at several sites have pushed back the antiquity of the Neolithic culture in mid-Ganga plain around the latter half of the 8th millennium before present and Vindhyan region to 7th millennium BC. Radiocarbon dates from Golbai Sasan and Sankrasan suggest duration of 2200 to 700 BC for the Neolithic culture of Sotanagpur region. In 1963, M.C. Goswami and T.C. Sharma carried out excavation at Dauzali Hading in North Kasar Hills of Assam, which have given for the first time stratigraphical occurrence of ground or polished axis and also of pottery. The Neolithic culture of Northeast India is distinguished by the predominance of shoulder cells and the characteristic court mark pottery. Now let's come to Southern Neolithic. The Neolithic culture of South India is primarily a product of human adaptation to semi-arid environment marked by low rainfall and found distributed in northern Karnataka and western Andhra Pradesh. Although a few sites also occur in southern Karnataka, coastal Andhra Pradesh, and northern Tamil Nadu. Some of the important excavated sites are Sangankalu, Teklakota, Brahmagiri, Maski, Piklihal, Wadgal, Halur, T. Narsipur, and Hamis of Karnataka. Nagarjunakonda, Ramapuram and Bhirapuram in Andhra Pradesh, and Payampali in Tamil Nadu. The stone tools of the Neolithic people consist of ground stone tools like axes, edges, wedges, chisels, microliths, and stone plates. Pottery was initially only handmade, but in the later stages wheel made. Sturdy pottery also came into use. An important new ceramic was the black and red ware. The domesticated animals comprised cattle, buffalo, sheep, goat, pig, dog, and fowl. The Neolithic people also cultivated a variety of crops on hilltops and in narrow valleys between the hills using rain-fed gravity flow irrigation, as also on alluvial banks of river. Their main crops were millet, pulses, and legumes. A very distinctive feature of the southern group of Neolithic culture is ash mound, which are heaps of ash produced by the burning of cow dung. The ash in the mounds consists of several distinct layers. In some layers, it is soft and loose, and in others, heavily vitrified, suggesting that cow dung was burned at varying temperatures. The contents of the ash include stone and bone tools, animal bones, and pottery. The Neolithic culture is dated by C14 dating from the middle of the 3rd millennium BC to the beginning of the 4th millennium BC. The next point is Northern Group. The Neolithic settlers of the northern India settled in the Pleistocene lake beds of Kashmir Valley, which are locally known as Karewas. The Neolithic people of the Kashmir Valley live in pits dug into the compact Karewa lois. These was to protect themselves from the freezing winds during winter. Evidence of ovens, charcoal, ash, pottery, stone tools, human burials, and animal bones indicate habitation in the pit. The pottery of this region is largely handmade. However, at a later stage, wheel-made pots also appeared. Vessel shapes comprise jars, vases, globular pots, basins. These on stain and balls. The subsistence pattern of the Kashmir Neolithic was combination of plant cultivation, animal husbandry, and hunting and gathering. Neolithic culture of northern Europe is dated to a time bracket of 2400 to 1500 BC, based on several uncalibrated carbon 14 dates from Burjahom. The new radiocarbon dates from Kanishkapura suggest the beginning of Neolithic age in Kashmir in the middle of the 4th millennium BC. Now let's come to the concluding part. The Neolithic culture of Europe is defined as the period started with the emergence of farming. Farming emerges in different regions of the continent differently. Thus, the Neolithic culture of Europe can broadly be divided into three chronological phases, like early Neolithic, middle Neolithic, and late Neolithic. And on the basis of the distribution and cluster of sites, Neolithic culture of India may broadly be divided into three groups. They are Eastern Group, Northern Group, and Southern Group. Thank you all for patient hearing.